So we were looking at this caravanserai. I was talking about the gatehouse. This is the gatehouse of the caravanserai, and I was saying this is also a kind of maktab. And maktab is an office. Office kya hai ta ki jo log aa rahe hain aur jo ja rahe hain unka ek record rakha jaye. So that was for the sake of security, and also to check the flow of the traffic. And you can see there is a road here, and there is a road here, and this the location of the caravanserai couldn't be better than this. Yet another caravanserai, similar thing, not much different from the other caravanserais, and another one. And these are the most of the caravanserais which are like this, all more square. This one is a bit rectangular, not a square, but otherwise they all were similar. This is the different one, and as you know that at every chamber, every room, there was a dome construction. And then this is a gatehouse, which is most like a pitch roof. And this is the distribution of spaces in the caravanserai. For example, this is the inner court, the green one. Then in front of each room, there is a kind of veranda, this blue one. In front of each room, there's a kind of veranda or a forecourt on the four rooms. And then this actual room is here. And then behind the actual room, there is a back room also for the sake of storage. Aapke saath kuch saman wagera hai, so you can keep it there safely while you live here. And there is a veranda in front of you, so three facilities. And then the gatehouse is here for the people coming in and going out. Then there is an area which is purplish here and here and here. And this area had three purposes. One was the storage. In caravanserai, you need lot of grocery and other things for the travelers. And for the animal, you need lot of fodders. And perhaps for the travelers, you also need a kind of clinic, which is known as mustashfa. In Arabic, they call it mustashfa. So these spaces were allocated for these things. Maybe one of these was also a kind of stable. Sometimes the stable used to be a separate small building adjacent to the main caravanserai. Now in Islamic history, there are two queens that have contributed tremendously toward building caravanserais. One of those queens is Zubaydah, the wife of Harun Rashid. Aur dusri queen hai ji Noor Jahan Begum, lived from 1577 and to 1645, wife of Jahangir. So these are the two ladies who contributed greatly toward the building of caravanserais. Whereas Zubaydah was doing it for the sake of common man, Noor Jahan was doing it for the sake of her husband or for the royal family. So there is a difference between the workmanship or the womanmanship of these two ladies. Her biggest achievement, that is the biggest achievement of Zubaydah, her biggest achievement was the planning and execution of a road project from Baghdad to Mecca. She saw the pilgrim dying with thirst and losing the way because of the desert and sandstorms. To solve this problem, Zubaydah planned to build a well-demarcated route with build-up walls and caravanserais to protect the traveler from shifting sands and harsh weather conditions. So this was her planning, that she wanted to construct a road from Baghdad to Mecca. It's a very, very long route. But nevertheless, she was able to get this road constructed. Not only get the road constructed, but that this road she built many caravanserais. And not only that, because of the shifting sand, where jahan bahut zyada sehra tha, aur sand jo shift hoti thi, wo sadkon pe upar aati, and the passage was lost, to usne sadkon ki dar taraf diwaare khadi kar di, so that the sand doesn't come on the road. The road aise to nahi tha jaise hum aaj samjhte hain, but brick paved, not brick paved, and sometimes the rubble paved road or the stone paved road. That is the demarcation. And then at various intervals, not only caravanserais, but also the water ponds, and that was a great contribution. She was a very religious lady, very, very religious lady. So it is stated in the books that if you go to her haram, so her uske haram mein har waqt ladies Quran Sharif padhti rehti thi. एंड यू वुड हियर द हमिंग साउंड जो तिलावत कर रही है, मुस्तकिल दिन रात तिलावत हो रही है. दैट वॉज अ टाइप ऑफ लेडी. शी वॉज सो मच कमिटेड टू इस्लाम एंड वेरी लर्नड लेडी ऑल्सो. And she was learned also because she was daughter of Mehdi and the granddaughter of Al-Mansur. Al-Mansur is the same person who built the city of Baghdad. But when he built the city of Baghdad, Khalifa Al-Mansur, it was not Baghdad, it was Al-Mansuriya. Uski baat karenge kisi time jab we will talk about the planning of the, or the city planning of the Abbasids. So that is her contribution. ज़ुबैदा बिन तजाफर, सॉरी मैंने आपको मेहदी का नाम बताया, शी इज़ बिन तजाफर इब्ने मंसूर, लिव्ड फ्रॉम दिस टाइम वाज़ द बेस्ट नोन ऑफ द अब्बासिड प्रिंसेसेस एंड द वाइफ ऑफ हारून. शी इज़ पर्टिकुलरली रिमेंबर्ड फॉर द सीरीज ऑफ वेल्स, रिजर्वॉयर्स एंड आर्टिफिशियल पूल्स दैट प्रोवाइडेड वाटर फॉर मुस्लिम पिलग्रिम्स अलोंग द रूट फ्रॉम बगदाद टू मक्का एंड मदीना, व्हिच वाज़ रीनेम्ड एज़ दरबे ज़ुबैदा इन हर ऑनर. The exploits of her and her husband Harun al-Rashid were part of the basis for the what we know as the famous storybook, now remembered as the Alif Laila wa Laila or the Thousands and One Nights. Yani 1000 aur ek raatein. So the actual name is Alif Laila wa Laila. Alif Laila. वाह लैला, 1001 तब बनेगी ना, एक और जमा करें आप. दैट इज द नेम ऑफ द बुक. नाउ व्हाट इज इनसाइड दिस बुक एंड व्हाट इज द बैकग्राउंड ऑफ दिस बुक. एक बादशाह था जो ऐसे करता था, रोज शादी करता था और सुबह बीवी को मरवा देता था,
सुबह मार देता था क्योंकि उसकी फर्स्ट जो बिलव्ड वाइफ थी उसने उससे बिट्रे किया होता है.
तो ये दूसरों का क्या कसूर है, ये तो गलत बात है. करे कोई और बड़े कोई, ये तो
बड़े
खाम खाम लेडी को भड़का रहे हैं. अल्टीमेटली एक लेडी आ गई ना, उसने कहा कि बादशाह को फिर एंजते फिर एंजी सही आई विल सी यू. तो उसने ऐसी स्टोरी शुरू की जो खत्म ही नहीं हो रही थी. कंटिन्यू द स्टोरी फॉर 1001 नाइट्स. ये कोई ज़्यादा देर तो नहीं बनती, मेरे ख्याल 3 साल ही बनते हैं हार्डली, इससे थोड़े से ज़्यादा या कम. बट अल्टीमेटली ड्यूरिंग द कोर्स ऑफ दीज स्टोरीज दीज नाइट्स बादशाह सलामत खुद पार हो गए, मर गए वो. The lady survived according to the story. Now this book has been translated in almost every language of the world. Ye kamal hai iska tarah ki, so popular. And it has three kind of stories. Kuch stories aisi hain jo bachcho ke liye hain. For example, the story of Ali Baba 40 Chor, Sindbad the Sailor. Is tarah ki kahaniyan jo hain wo bachcho ke liye bade acche hain. Bachche padhte hain, hum bhi padhte rahe bachpan mein. फिर कुछ यंग लोगों के लिए, बड़ों के लिए जो बेस्ड ऑन हिस्ट्री, तो उनके लिए इंटरमेशन. फिर उससे भी एक हैं जो बड़ी वो क्या कहते हैं इरोटिक टाइप के हैं, वल्गर स्टोरीज भी हैं बहुत सी. तो समटाइम जो गेट द ट्रांसलेशन ऑफ दिस बुक में जो वल्गर स्टोरीज हैं निकाल देते हैं उसमें. अदरवाइज गेट होल्ड ऑफ द होल बुक तो आप देखेंगे 50% ऑफ द स्टोरीज आर वेरी वेरी डर्टी. लेकिन अच्छी स्टोरीज भी हैं एंड सम स्टोरीज व्हिच हैव द लेसन विद देम. सो दैट इज द बैकग्राउंड ऑफ द 1001 नाइट्स. तो ये उसकी बुक है जो बहुत से लैंग्वेजेस में ट्रांसलेट हो गई है और बड़े बड़े मशहूर लोगों ने इसको ट्रांसलेट किया. फॉर एग्जांपल, दिस मैन हुज नेम इज सर रिचर्ड बर्टन, ही इज अ ग्रेट ओरिएंटलिस्ट. उसने बहुत सी किताबों की ट्रांसलेट किया. एंड देन दिस इज अनदर ट्रांसलेटर. And then it is translated into French also. So iski koi hisab hi nahi hai ki itni translations hai, itni translation hai. That is unlimited editions in all languages. Coming back to Zubaida, our engineers drew up a map of over 1200 kilometers. The road was divided into more than 40 stations for shelter of huge caravans of pilgrims with their animals. Deep wells, water pools, caravanserais, mosques, and police posts were erected to provide comfort and security. High minarets were raised to locate the place, and in the night towers were lit with fire to guide the caravans to the right direction. So ye dekhiye kitna kuch kar diya usne. Towers bhi khade kar diye, raat ko ke upar aag bhi jala dete the, so that the caravan come to the actual site. and then lavishly provision of the wells and water pools, and then the caravanserai, the mosque. So what else you and traveler needed during those days? So she must have spent a lot of money for this, on this project. But great project it was. All these structures were so strong that they remained intact for centuries. The result was that there was a weather surge for more than 1,000 years for millions of pilgrims from Iraq, Iran, Khorasan, and Kurdistan. Though about 1,300 years have passed, some of the wells and pools of this route can still be identified. So, kuch kuch pool maine bhi dekhe hain iske Iraq mein aur uske aage. They are still there. So, to dekhe banda sochta hai ki jis waqt in pe movements ho gaye when they were being used, to unki kya shaan hogi. This is a little biography of the lady. And Zubaydah, incidentally, Zubaydah is from an Arabic root word is Zebedal, Zubd. And from Zebedal we have Zubda. Zubda kehte hain makhan ko. So Zubaydah means makhan ki jo ek goli hoti hai, usko kehte hain Zubaydah. Makhan ki ek tikiya keh lein ka. So that is the meaning of the Zubaydah. Jaise hum bahut se mufakkiron ke liye we use the term Zubdatul Hukma. Ya jo hakeem hai, jo knowledgeable log hai, unke ye unka nichod hai. That is known as Zubdatul Hukma. Now this is the Darb-e Zubaydah, starting from Baghdad, traveling to Kufa and Najaf and then Zabla. I'll give you the name of all these stations that goes to here. But at Fez, it is bifurcated in two routes, one going this way for the sake of joining other cities, and one going to the straight to the Medina, and then down to Mecca. What long route it is? So this is the building of this road, which is known as Darb-e Zubaydah. And this is one of the pond, and if you look at the picture of this pond, you can visualize the size of this pond, how big it is and how deep it is. And when it was full of water, it must have been a great scene. And this is a closer view of the same thing, and the water coming from the outside and getting into this pond. And these impressions on the wall give you the idea. Once upon a time, the level of the water was this much, and it was this much, and this much. This must be a recent mark on the walls, not the old one. But they, again, nevertheless, give you an idea of the various levels of the water which was in this pond once upon a time. And culverts on the same route, and there's a road is passing over it, and then there is a pond underneath, and yet another pond with the two wells on the side of this. And this is an underground passage for the water. And the steps going down into the pond. And this may be, I'm not sure what this structure is, but it may be one of the toilets or lavatories in on the side of the pond, or maybe some other room for the sake of the rest, or maybe some kind of a room on the side of the great pond. And here, this is the surviving passage of the caravanserai made of stones. And on the side, there is the surviving part of the canal or a well. And this canal or well continues, starts from here, comes here, and goes down here. So a long passage, a longish kind of well over here. And this is yet another well which still survives. And on the side of the great pond, several rooms must be. So that is yet another one. So these are the maybe the hammam kalenko and the chambers for taking baths or some other recreation. Could be lavatories also. These are the coins and of the Harun al-Rashid which have been used. Aapke interest ka to nahi hai, but nevertheless, I thought I should show you the coins which are made of gold and bronze. Now, when we're talking about Darb-e Zubaydah, Darb-e Zubaydah is actually, when we use the word Darb, it is like Shara, let's say, the Shara-e Qaid-e-Azam. So there's a difference between Shara-e and there's a difference between the road or the street. In the same way, the when we use the term darb, it is like a GT row. You're connecting one place with another place, or which is very, very important. That is known as a darb. On the other hand, if the road is of smaller significance, air rodeo, maybe it is also connecting. It is an intercity route. So, choti hai, lekin usko kehte hain tariq. Now, one of the stones which have been found on the side of this this passage, it shows that, and if you read it carefully, it says al tariq al kufa, al this year al tariq al kufa, and maybe this road jo hai kufa ki taraf ja rahi hai. Maybe one of the offshoots of this road, which was known as the offshoot, and which was going toward Kufa. So this is an epigraph found on this route, and the script is the old Kufi, and this script is known as rectangular Kufi because most of the angles are 90 degrees angles. These caravans rise with mosque were built at a day's journey by camel. So the ek camel se aap itna journey kar sakte hain ek din mein, to usne utne faasle pe ye caravans rise banaye gaye. These caravans rise were free, and free food was provided over here. Free first aid and allied services were also provided. A stable for animal with fodder free of cost. And then she also introduced the bareed system, which is known as the postal system. ताकि अगर किसी ने खत भेजना है मदर से बगदाद से मक्का मदीना तो वो खत भी पहुंच जाए. सो दिस ही इंट्रोड्यूस्ड द पोस्टल सिस्टम आल्सो एंड दैट इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट रिमार्केबल पार्ट ऑफ दिस रूट के वो खत कैसे पहुंचता था. इफ यू लुक एट दिस मैप नाउ द पर्सन और द हॉर्समैन और द कैमल मैन हु वाज फंक्शनिंग फॉर द पोस्टल सिस्टम इट वाज लाइक दिस. फॉर एग्जांपल वन हॉर्समैन या पोस्टमैन इज लोकेटेड हियर. तो इस पोस्टमैन का जो इलाका है वो यहाँ से दो तक है और तीन से चार तक है. इससे आगे वो नहीं जा सकता. सो ही विल कैरी अ लेटर फ्रॉम हियर टू हियर और टू दिस प्लेस एंड दैट इज द जॉब फिनिश. फ्रॉम हियर टू हियर इट इज द जॉब ऑफ दिस पर्सन नाउ. सो एवरी पोस्टमैन वॉज कवरिंग थ्री स्टेशन. द सेंट्रल स्टेशन वॉज हिज परमानेंट स्टेशन. सो एनी लेटर विच हैज अराइव्ड हियर फ्रॉम दिस सोर्स he will take it to this place and this place will go to this place. And this is how the letter was traveling from one destination to another destination. And this area, which was under the control of one postman, was technically known as a beat. And it is still known as a beat in the language of the post offices. So is tarah letter jo yahan se chalta tha, that could reach the end of the destination. So this was another achievement of Zubaydah. The Zubaydah started from Baghdad and passing through Kufa, Najaf, Qadisiya, and many other stations. It reached the Mecca and Medina. So this is the all the stations which were covered by this route are shown here. The Zubaydah also mobilized the cultural and commercial activity in the region. Pilgrims exchanged their ideas, delivered sermons, told historical stories and reached commercial dealing during the night stays. So the guys were sitting together and gossiping. So ideas were exchanged, and not that they were exchanged, but the knowledge were also exchanged. Besides the exchange of the goods and so on, this route remained active for 6 months every year for Hajj traffic, and for the rest of the period served the locals and traders. It is said that the Zubaydah spent 700,000 miskal on this project, or this project, which is equal to 5,950 kilograms of pure gold. Imagine करें कि 5,950 किलोग्राम सोना इसकी बनाई पे लग गया. And if you calculate that amount of money, that amount of gold converted into dollars, you will feel that it is a fortune. It's great, great, great fortune. Nobody could afford to do today, and sadly enough, none of our rulers have dared to do or take up a project like this. Very sad.